Welcome to Learnpedia, the 24/7 JEE and NEET resource at your fingertips. Now let's look at this actual JEE question and see if you can answer that. If you think you got the answer, then post it in the comment section below. To know the best way to answer this question, continue watching this video.
First, let us study the growth of current in series LR circuit. We have a battery connected here. This is the positive terminal of the battery. This is the negative terminal of the battery. This is key. In the given circuit, we have a resistance R and inductor L. Consider a circuit having an inductor and resistor in series with a direct source of EMF E. As soon as the switch is closed, the current in the resistor starts increasing. If the inductor was not present, the current would rise rapidly and immediately the steady state current will reach, that is called E by R. I is equal to, by Ohm's law, E by R. Because of the inductor, however, self-induced EMF is developed across the inductor. E is equal to L di by dt in the opposite direction. That much EMF appears in the circuit. From Lenz's law, this EMF opposes the rise of current, which means opposes the battery EMF, that is the external EMF capital E. Therefore, there will be a net EMF developed in the circuit, E minus L di by dt. And this EMF, net EMF, should provide the total current in the circuit, and that current, if suppose we say call I, it should be equal to I into R. Or using Kirchhoff law, we can calculate the value of current in terms of resistance R and the inductor L. So let us calculate the value of the total current flowing in the circuit. So consider a circuit having inductor and resistor in series with a direct current source of EMF E. As soon as the switch is closed, the current in the resistor starts increasing. If the inductor were not present, the current would rise rapidly to a steady value, E by R. Now, because of the inductor, however, self-induced EMF, E is equal to L di by dt, appears from Lenz's law, it is in the opposite direction. This EMF opposes the rise of the current. Therefore, a net EMF is in the circuit. That will be the actual EMF external capital E minus the EMF generated across the inductor, that is L di by dt. Di by dt is the rate at which the current is changing. So, the current starts flowing in the circuit when the switch is closed. Here, there will be an induced EMF and this will be E is equal to L di by dt. And across resistor, we know the potential drop is I into R. Total EMF is E. The current starts circulating. EMF is in the opposite direction. The current moves in the direction clockwise. So we can use, using Kirchhoff law, using Kirchhoff's loop rule, we can write the equation as E minus IR minus L di by dt is equal to 0. So L di by dt can be written as E minus IR. So, all I terms will bring together, left out terms the other side. Di divided by E minus IR can be written as dt by L. Integrating both sides of the equation, we get integration from 0 to I. Di divided by E minus IR, that is equal to integration 0 to t dt by L. So, we will get this one as ln of E minus IR divided by minus R. Limits from 0 to I equal to T by L. Substituting the limits, ln of E minus IR minus ln E, this should be equal to T by L. So, we can write ln of E minus IR by E should be equal to minus T by LR. Minus R is there, this will come over here. So, this will be minus TR by L. So, we can get the value as ln of E minus IR by E should be equal to minus T by L by R. So, that all ln term we can bring towards this side. So, we can write this one as E minus IR by E should be equal to E to the power minus T by L divided by R. So, IR can be written as E taken common 1 minus E to the power T by L divided by R. Or I is equal to E by R into 1 minus E to the power T by L by R. Now here two things we will substitute. One is E by R, let me call this as the maximum current, equal to I naught. I naught is maximum current. Similarly, L by R, let me put it as called tau. This is called time constant. Then, this equation we can write it as I is equal to I naught 1 minus e to the power t by tau. This is how the current will grow in the LR circuit. If we differentiate it di by dt, we can get how the current is going to decrease in the given circuit. The value of current at any instant of time after closing the circuit during the rising of current is given as I is equal to I naught 1 minus e to the power t by 2, where I naught is the maximum current, which is nothing but E by R, which we also call as the steady current. The value of current at any instant of time t after closing the circuit, that is we have taken during the rising of current, will be I is equal to I naught 1 minus e to the power t by tau. This is the value of current at an instant of time t after closing the circuit, that is during the rising of current. I naught we have chosen, I naught is equal to, that is the maximum current, which is equal to E by R. It is also called steady state current.
I hope you can now answer the question. Take a look at the solution now. Hit the bell icon below and subscribe to our Learnpedia channel to learn more through such interesting videos. Learnpedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain over 4,000 videos and 20,000 solved examples. They are accessible online on our website and also offline through SD card or a pen drive. To buy now, visit www.learnpedia.in. You can also try a free demo of our product on our website.